The new medical graduate Vasudev Raghavendra Bhat wanted to get a postgraduate qualification, and he chose the subject of tuberculosis to get his postgraduate diploma. Tuberculosis was one of the main diseases in India which caused untold misery to the people. A large number of people of all ages were affected by it, leading to prolonged morbidity and higher incidence of mortality. It was in 1939 that the government of British India intensified its campaign against tuberculosis and established many hospices called sanatoria in the country. A sanatorium is a hospital for taking care of very sick patients of TB who would otherwise have no place to go except the footpaths of desolate roads. Such a sanatorium was established in Chennai, and doctors were appointed as trainees to work there. In 1942, when Dr. Vasudev R. Bhat got his MBBS degree and registration certificate to practice medicine, he took the opportunity to work in the sanatorium. After the marriage, both husband and wife lived in Chennai in a rented house close to the sanatorium. Vasudev completed his course of tuberculosis diseases diploma, or TDD, in 1944. This group photograph shows his classmates and teachers. Another photograph shows him being felicitated along with other new doctors by the SGS Society of Chennai in 1945. Vasudev Bhat continued his job in the sanatorium to gain more experience until 1947, and then moved to Mangalore to begin his practice. He opened his clinic on 17th August 1947, just 2 days after India gained independence from the British rule. He returned to the same house that belonged to his maternal grandmother with his wife. Dr. V.R. Bhat became popular instantly in Mangalore, and his practice picked up very soon. He became very busy within a year of starting his practice. He applied for and got the position of a lecturer in the Kasturba Medical College and of an honorary physician specialized in tuberculosis at the Wenlock Hospital in Mangalore. Dr. V.R. Bhat was appointed as the honorary visiting physician at the Moodshedde TB Sanatorium soon after. Moodshedde Sanatorium is located about 14 kilometers from Mangalore. Dr. V.R. Bhat followed the prevalent traditions of medical practice in Mangalore. This is a sketch map of Mangalore roads, and Dr. V.R. Bhat's residence is at number 1 in Gandhinagar. His clinic was about 3 kilometers from home in the central area of Mangalore town, known as Hampankatta, at number 2. To attend to his honorary position of physician at the Wenlock Hospital at number 3, located at Hampankatta across the street from his clinic, he could walk between the clinic and the hospital easily. Thank you. This is Hampankatta Circle, the Wenlock Hospital seen in the background. This is the row of shops opposite Dr. V. R. Bhatt's clinic in 1972. Once the private practice was begun and there was steady income, the couple decided to raise a family. Meera became pregnant and delivered a baby girl on 2nd February 1948. They named the child Chitra. Baby Chitra grew up to be about 6 years old when Meera became pregnant again and delivered a baby boy on 19th June 1955. They named him Raghavendra after the paternal grandfather. It was a tradition prevalent among the Indian families to name the first male child after the paternal grandfather in those days. After the birth of Chitra, Dr. V. R. Bhatt renamed his clinic as Chitra Clinic. In addition to the duties at the government Wenlock Hospital and the private clinic, V. R. Bhatt traveled to the Moodshed Sanatorium once or twice a week. Therefore, a transport vehicle was a necessity, and he purchased a second-hand car, Morris Minor. You can see his daughter Chitra sitting on the bonnet of the car. Later, he purchased a new Fiat car. Dr. V. R. Bhatt bought an X-ray machine and set it up in his clinic so that his patients can get the X-ray done at his clinic rather than go to the hospital, where they had to wait in a long line for hours together. Dr. V. R. Bhatt charged reasonable fees for his services and also dispensed medicines in his clinic. The price of the medicines was included in the consultation fees. At this time, Dr. V. R. Bhatt wrote a book on tuberculosis in Kannada language with many illustrations, which explained in full details the complete information on the disease for laymen as well as medical practitioners of Karnataka state. In his book, Dr. V. R. Bhatt described the normal anatomy of lungs and other structures that are commonly affected by tuberculosis. He explained how a person may contract pulmonary tuberculosis from inhaling infected droplets from a cough or sneeze by an infected person. He then wrote in detail the findings in an X-ray film of an affected person. The book was published by him under the banner of Chitra Prakashana Mandira on 25/6/1953.